Hello, Michelle. I finished my 1 week sketchbook school course that was called How Art Can Make You Happy. And it seems to be a case of mismatched expectations or incorrect expectations. I didn't enjoy it. A lot of the people who took the course raved about it at the end, but I was, it was not my bag, baby. So I guess I had thought that there might be a bit of very general kind of art history kind of talked about, general periods, talking about how you can find really interesting stories in the works and, you know, some interesting examples to give you a taste of, like, you know, looking deeper into some of, you know, say there's a painting of just a woman standing still and then there's an empty bowl in the room as well. But, you know, if you delve deeper, that there's like this whole interesting backstory, or like, you know, the more religious paintings where there's like an angel with a halo and then there's some other strange creatures in the picture, like telling an interesting story about that to help you really get into the exciting stories that can be behind art. And then, you know, similarly, different ways to help you appreciate art, like here are five things that you can do if you could go in an art gallery. You can try to just sketch exactly what you see the same way, or you can like let yourself feel inspired and then you can draw something or write something based on how you're feeling, and maybe let's all do that and then let's share our stuff with each other. But yeah, it wasn't any of that. Like, one of the little learning videos was about, you might have some art books at home. Of course you will have some art books at home. Here's how you can enjoy your art books. Get a glass of wine and sit down with an art book. And I'm just like, well, firstly, I don't have any art books, so you're cutting me out of your intended audience by omitting people who don't own any and don't know where to start with an art book. Like, you know, there's a section at the library and it just overwhelms me. I don't know, what to look at. And then secondly, like, if a person can't think that they might pull out an art book and sit down with a glass of wine and look through it, it just seemed really sort of simple and silly. And yeah, and there was a bit of talk about, you know, have a look at what art museums are near you and think about going to the big ones, but think about going to smaller ones. And I feel like we can all do that, but it's kind of like the next step that needs to happen. It's like the kick up our butt that we need. We almost need an assignment to do, like go there and find X, or go there and do an exercise, a drawing exercise, or something like that. Anyway, it wasn't what I expected. That's okay. It was like a $30 1 week thing. And as I said, a lot of people did enjoy it. I found a couple of old discs. One was like a floppy disk, which I don't even know how to look at. One was, I think, like a mini disc, which I also don't know how to look at. And there was also a DVD or a CD. DVD, I guess, with files. And I borrowed my dad's portable DV drive to look at the files that were on this disc. And yeah, it was a whole bunch of files from 2000. So that was super weird. Oh my God, I just find it so weird looking at things from the past. Like, it gives me actually a really creepy feeling. I feel like I'm being voyeuristic on another, like, because it's in like another version of yourself. It's not you now. It's like, you, but it's another you. I felt really kind of creepy looking at these things, and I don't keep things from the past. I think pretty much for this reason that I find it very voyeuristic and I don't particularly enjoy looking at old things. Like, you can get a kind of thrill, like, oh my goodness, I didn't remember that I wrote from the university magazine in 2000, and you know, I get this really strange twinge of like, I recognize these things, but at the same time, the way that I wrote actually seemed so much better than the way that I wrote now. It seemed like more articulate, better written than I do now. But anyway, I didn't remember a lot of the stuff that was on there. And there was one text file that I still haven't even gone through all the stuff on the disk. I've saved it all to my desktop so that I can gradually go through it and see what I want to sort of keep more long term, and what I want to discard. But I found a little text file on there with my first URLs. So the history kind of started out 1998. I had a GeoCities website called Dylan Knight. So like the word Dylan, but then the word Knight squished together, Dylan Knight. And that's not in the Wayback Machine, so I can't see that. I think that was my website that said Trip the Light Fantastic, and it had a lot of images from the movie Labyrinth on it. And then shortly after, 1999, was our first website, which was called Four, and it was a pretend golf club, and that is in the Wayback Machine. I will show a little bit of the first couple of pages of that, but I am not going to show the part where it gets into our diary, because, oh my goodness, the things that I wrote in there were so horrible. Like, I was such a, you know, I still am sometimes, as per my last video, but such a horrible person, did some really awful things, in that time of my life. So, you know what it's like when you look back on like teenage diaries and all that sort of stuff. Even though I was older then, so I should have known better. I was thinking about what my favorite moments of 2017. Two things immediately sprang to mind. One was your art supplies package, which you bought me the sketchbook school course and sent me an art supplies package. And I can't tell you how excited I was to open this package up and to see paints and paint brushes and pencils and everything, because I think one of the hardest thing to do when you're starting out in a new area of interest is not feeling too precious about the stuff that you get and actually wanting to use it. So by you giving me a beginner set of like watercolor paints and acrylic paints and everything, I feel like I can use them. Like, some, I don't know how much they cost. I didn't have to, you know, in a shop about whether I was going to spend $10 or $20 or $40 or $80 and then be lumped with that afterwards, like, oh, you know, I'm using this $40 paints, and you know, I didn't have to choose which paintbrushes, they were just there, and it was just such an amazing gift. It was so thoughtful and it was so helpful, and thank you so, so much. I wish that I might one day enable you in some way that you're just like, oh, that is the best thing. But anyway, that was one favorite. And the other favorite was that I don't know what made me or gave me the idea, but I just signed up for this local painting class, and every week I've been looking forward to it, and every week I have been savoring and enjoying every second of it, even like walking from the car with my box of stuff into the room and setting up with my two glasses of water, you know, just every single part of it I've been enjoying. And the exercise that they do each time, even when it hasn't been something that looks particularly good in the end, I've just been enjoying it so much, and I feel like I will continue learning so much from it, because it's so hard when you're at home and you're like, I know that I want to get better with, like, I know that I want to get better with drawing, and so I'm going to go through this book, Drawing on the Right Side of the Brain, but I also want to get better with painting. And it's just so good to have someone tell you, okay, we're going to do this thing where we're just concentrating on painting the background today, and this is the way we're going to approach it. And you feel like you really learn something. I've been saving so many pictures of other people's artwork, things that I want to give a go, like emulating, and not because I want to like copy their style and profit off that, but because I want to learn how to do that, and by learning how to do all these different kinds of things, then hopefully I will learn new techniques and get better and better. And this is one that I tried a couple of nights ago. I tried a hanging basket, but it looks more like my hair. So I need to, I'm gonna ask my dad. I think I chose the wrong brush to do it, and I think that maybe I need to water down the paints a bit more to get them flowing more smoothly, and I might even be using the wrong kind of paper. But anyway, they are, I think, my two favorite, you know, non-kid moments / memories of 2017 was the art supplies package and the painting class. And yeah, just really looking forward to going into the new year with both of those things by my side still. Lastly, I was gonna say, would you be interested in doing art projects on Monaco next year? So for example, once a month we think of like an exercise that we do, like drawing the things on our desk and then filling that in with watercolor, or I try and find something online, some particular exercise or technique or something like that, and we both give it a bash and sort of film it and share it, or we think up our own sorts of things to do. I kind of thought that might be fun. Bye, I love you, bye, I love you, bye, I love you, bye, I love you.